Yo, peace was good. Welcome to the Soul My City Collection. This is part 80. Wow, 80, that's crazy. Alright? Without further ado, show you guys some of the CDs that I got. The rest of the CDs from the batch that I just did. Alright? Next album I want to show you guys is Far Side with Plain Rap, released in 2000. You guys should know who Far Side is. I showed you the first two albums. They covered my videos and stuff like that a while back. This album was different. It was different, you know what I mean? Production-wise, was definitely different. Wasn't really that good, to be honest with you. The only thing creative I like about this is the fact that it has like the, you know, kind of like the receipt effect to it. I like that. That's pretty cool. The single of the album, I think the only single of the album is Trust. That was like the only single of the album. But I was a little bit disappointed with this album, man. I feel like it could have been a lot better. I think at the time, I think Fatlip had left the group. He wasn't in the group anymore. I think because they had like some internal beef going around at that time too. One of the members left. I don't remember. I don't know if it was Fatlip or Booty Brown or what. One of the two, but I think it was Fatlip that left the group, and you know, this hasn't been the same since. And production-wise, it really wasn't that good. So, but Trust was like the only single of the album. Felt it could have been a little bit better, but that's just my opinion. Far Side with Plain Rap, released in 2000. Then we got Joel Santana with his second album, What the Game's Been Missing. This is released in 2005. I have this is like the deluxe edition. You know, I had to pick this up, you know what I mean? I have his first album. I forgot the name of that shit. I think it's called For Me to You. I believe that was the name of the single. I mean, not the single, the name of the album, For Me to You. Very dope album. I like it, you know what I mean? Some of my subscribers might not like that, but growing up back in high school, my junior year in high school, the album was definitely one of the biggest albums that came out in 2003. You know, Dipset at that time was like reigning supreme, especially in New York. Even down here in Florida, you know, cats, you know, especially on my New York transplants that lived out here, you know, they definitely were, you know, repping that shit and shit like that, repping Dipset and all that shit. I mean, to the point, yeah, niggas is fucking, you had niggas that had Bird Gang and Dipset, and it was fucking crazy. I mean, it's, yeah, I'm not really getting into all that, but yeah, you actually had fake ass gangs called Bird Gang and Dipset and all that shit. It was crazy. But, so getting back to that album, to this album, this is the second album. The singles off the album are, let me see, track list, I'm sorry. But I know it was Shanta's, Mic Check, The Whistle Song, which it was hot, but it got annoying quickly, very quickly. It was like one of those annoying songs, but I know if you play that song in the club now, like, you know, niggas will go in, and girls, you know, they be going in on that song. So, There It Go, The Whistle Song, Make It Work For You, Shatta's, Mic Check was a single as well. Dope video, too. It was like they're in the classroom, you see, you know, Rakim in the background and shit like that. That was pretty cool. But very good album. To me, the last good album he ever put out. Because anything after that, you know, he started doing this whole Bird Gang bullshit, and it wasn't really that good. Production-wise, like the production that he was doing, he was kind of straying towards like how music is now, especially New York now, when niggas is rapping over trap music and shit like that, which is whack in my opinion. I don't really fuck with it, you know what I mean? But very good album. It's been rumored that, you know, I was just going by what Wikipedia says, but I would like to hear those tracks that he recorded. But it said he recorded up to like 160 songs for this album, which is why the album was a little bit long, because this album has like 22 tracks. But yeah, I think that's pretty dope. I love when artists do that. They record like, a whole bunch of songs and then they just record it and shit like that. And yeah, they just cut through, you know, whatever songs they need for the album and stuff like that. I really like that. So, but yeah, I like both albums, but if I had to choose, I'll probably have to say this album is a little bit better than the first album. Even though the first album got some joints, but this album, the production was a little bit better. I don't know, there's some songs I could have done without with this album. There were some songs on the first album I could have done without, but overall, if I grabbed a couple of the songs the songs I like from Me to You and some of the songs off this album, I just put in one album, it would be a perfect album. But you know how that goes. But yeah, Juwan Santana is his second album, What the Game's Been Missing. This is released in 2005. This is the deluxe edition. It comes with a DVD and stuff like that. So I thought that was pretty cool. So glad to own this genre. And that's probably out of print too. So then we got MC Lyte with her fifth album, Bad As I Wanna Be, released in 1996. With this album, she kind of went more commercial. She started going more commercial now. She kind of was going for the whole bad boy sound, if that makes sense, you know. You know what I mean? Just the same thing with her last album that she put on, her second album, no, her seventh album, 7-7, which I didn't really care for. Her sixth album, I think it's called. No, I'm sorry. Her sixth album, 7-7, because this came out in 1996. This was her fifth album. The next album was 7-7 that came out in 98, which I showed you guys a couple weeks ago, which I didn't really care for. But this album was a little bit better than 7-7. A lot better, you know, even though it was like on a more commercial tip. But you got joints like Core Rock the Party. I mean, that's a classic song right there. Let's put the singles of the album. Core Rock the Party, Keep On, featuring Escape. Those are the two singles of the album. But Core Rock the Party, I mean, the remix to that shit, oh my god, with Puffy or Diddy, I mean, that shit, right? That's one thing, I'll give Diddy that shit. Like, back in the 90s, he definitely, you know, when it came to, like, club tracks, he was, especially in the 90s, he reigned supreme on that shit, so I'll give him that. Even to this day, like, when you play some of those songs, yo, that shit is rock. You rocking out to a party. You go to a club, you play that shit, it was gonna go fucking crazy with them shits, man. So I'll give him that. But getting back to this album, it was good. You know, not her best album, but it's decent. Even though it's like on a more commercial tip, but I do like it. I fucks with it. So, but yeah, MC Lyte, Core As I Wanna Be, released in 1996. This album was a little disappointed. I was a little disappointed. And it's not because of the album itself. I can't really judge the album because I didn't really hear it. And I'll tell you the reason why. Let me see how much time I got left. Alright. Reason being is because, well, let me show you guys the album. The album is Too Short's fourth album, Shorty the Player, released in 1992. Alright. The original version of this album is called Shorty the Pimp. Okay? What I didn't know when I picked it up was that Shorty the Player is actually the edited version of this album. Shorty the Pimp is the explicit version, the dirty version, the one I wanted. But I didn't know that, you know what I'm saying? I didn't know the difference. I don't know what's so bad about calling saying pimp. Like, I don't know. Why is that a bad word? But apparently back in the 90s, that was considered a bad word, which makes no fucking sense to me. But I wanted to enjoy the song, but the fact that it was edited, it kind of turned me off, to be honest with you. But I will pick this album up, pick the Shorty the Pimp, and I'll definitely be picking up more Too Short albums, because, you know, shout out to Mike Sayers. He told me, yo, you need to get more of his albums. I definitely will do that, my dude. You know, definitely will, because I do have a couple of his. I do have the Getting It On album, and I really like that joint, so definitely need to get the rest of his album, at least his 90s stuff and his 80s stuff as well. But I know the single off the album is In the Trunk, was a single. I think that was it. And what's interesting with this album was an introduction to his crew, the Dangerous Crew, which consisted of a whole shitload of people. Goldie, Ant Banks, Too Short himself. I mean, a shitload of people. But this album definitely introduced the Dangerous Crew to the whole world and stuff like that. So this album is definitely, it is definitely like a important part of his career and stuff like that. So yeah, Too Short with Shorty the Pimp or Player. Shorty the Player is the edited version. Shorty the Pimp is the dirty version. So just be aware of that. I didn't know that. Because like, I was listening to some of the songs. I was like, okay, I like the production. It's sounding dope. But I'm noticing like I'm like, hold up. I'm not hearing any curses. Like, what the fuck? So I had to check the lyrics. I went to ola.com, O-H-H-L-A or O-H-H-L-A. And I was checking the lyrics and I was just playing the songs and stuff like that. And I'm like, oh, this shit is fucking edited, man. So that kind of pissed me off, you know what I mean? But I only paid $2.99, so I'm not that mad. But, you know, I guess this would be like a collector's item, I guess. But, yeah. So I definitely will be picking up the dirty version one of these days. So, yeah, Too Short the Player, released in 1992. So this is the edited version. Last but not least, finally got my hands on this album. And I got a funny story with this album. And that album is Flesh and Bones debut album, Thugs, which stands for, which is the acronym for Truths Humbly United Gathering Souls. This was released in 1986. What's funny is that Flesh and Bone is the first artist, or the first MC out of the Bone Thugs and Harmony group to come out with a solo album, which is kind of crazy because you would think like Crazy Bone or Busy Bone, with them being like the stars of the group at that time, would have come out the album first. Busy Bone didn't come out with the album until like 98. I forgot the name of it, and I've heard it years ago, back in 2003. My boy Steve had that album, and that shit is dope. I need to get my hands on that. But yeah, but very dope album. The singles off the album was World So Cruel. I'm sorry, I'm cheating right now. So World So Cruel, Nothing But the Bone in Me, and Playhead, which was the singles of the album. Very, very dope album, very underrated. I rarely hear people talk about this album, especially when it comes to Bone Thugs. You know, people always talk about Creeping on the Come Up. People always talk about East 1999, East Eternal. People always talk about Art of War. But I rarely hear people talk about this album. Let alone like their solo albums. I rarely hear people talk about their solo albums. But this is a very great album. Very dark, very underrated. You know, it talks about religion, it talks about murder, you know, it's just about, you know, evil spirits and all that shit and things like that. Definitely his best album. I'm just saying that because this is like the only album he ever put that I've heard from him. And then throughout the years, he's just been in trouble with the law, like to the point where he had like a sort of shotgun and shit like that. He was like at his cousin's house or some shit like that, and he got into some shit with some dude and shit like that. And he pointed a gun at him, and you know, in broad daylight, which was crazy. And he did some time for that. So I know he put out an album back in 2000. And he was in jail for like, I think close to like 8 years, 8 to 10 years or some shit like that. So he was like MIA from the rap game and shit like that. So, but Flesh and Bone, yeah, very dope album by him. The Thugs album. And funny story with this album is that, I don't know if you guys remember, but remember when I said that when I bought the Gangsta Nip album from a thrift store for $3, it was like $3 and change, it came to like $4, almost a $4 and shit, right? So when I got the Gangsta Nip, this album was there as well, but I had to choose because I didn't have that much money. I really literally only had like $4 on me, and I think like $4 and change, like some shit like that. I didn't have that much money, so I had to choose either this album or the Gangsta Nip. And I'm glad I picked the Gangsta Nip because that album was, you know, long out of print and goes for stupid money online. So, but let me see how much time I got left. All right, I gotta cut it short. But hope you guys enjoyed that video. Stay tuned for more. Peace.